Vedanta. There's two Venuses. There's a Venus, that's Urzuli Frida, and then there's Urzuli Danta, which is more of the African type one. Urzuli Frida is a mulatto that comes, that formulates in the West. Urzuli Danta is one that comes from the continent. And so that image of that African Venus for the people is the only two color pictures you get, but that one is also Urzuli Danta. And all, and she has her story when you deal with mythology. Yes. All right.
You too. Thank you for calling in. Let's see if we can get another question in here. We have 11 minutes to go. So next caller calling in from area code 312, please ask your question for Brother Bobby Hemet.
Hello.
312.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, we can.
Yeah, all right. You know, people be talking about all this 2012 and shit. Like, I don't really think they understand what's going on, and I'm really tired of them asking questions. I want to know as far as, like, the solar system is concerned, because we got Kundalini as far as the other planets is, like, heating up also. Is this just for the solar system, or is it going for the whole universe?
No, this is the whole universe.
That's what I thought. And what about the Omex? Like, they talk about, I'm trying to find information on the Omex, and it's like very little information. You know what I'm saying? You got anything?
Yes,
you know what I'm saying? Further?
There's one book that came out recently on them, but I'm going to tell you what the Omex are. The Omex existed in a time when it was, they were actually, whoever built those heads, they were actually, those Omex were the gods. They were
right.
A deity system. They were a deity system. And so there's only one way to do it. That means that the information about them was oral and never was translated into text. Just like that Apanuk, that three-headed lion deity, was oral and was never translated into text, the one that was in Nubia that I talked about earlier. Well, what you have to do with that, if you want to find out more about them, you have to go through the channel realm of the Akashic Records. And you get the information from them through the Akashic Records with any good psychic or any good person that can tap in. I just so happen to have one of the best on the planet, but she can't work with nobody but me. That's why I don't even loan her out. Because she can't get nothing. But when she calls, you don't have to do no breathing or nothing. All we got to do is call up. This thing's no different than calling the gods up on the telephone. It's just that fast. They are right there with it. But the only thing about it here, it was a relationship that was made for me with her because she can't do that for nobody else and stuff.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? So what you want to do is find you a good one and tap in. And this is just a good question you had to come up, because this is a way that we can find out things about our people. There's more than one way. We don't have to have written text, all this stuff. Nothing is never destroyed. There's whole libraries and Akashic Records we can tap into. So what you want to do is go to the Akashic realm. You might be able to do it yourself. Go in and have confidence on what is coming to you, and it'll come to you like thoughts. It might not be voices at first. It'll come like thoughts, and they can channel the information and the history for you. People do it every day. It's just that we don't realize, a lot of times we don't know that there's several ways to get information, especially the information that was in an oral tradition. And a lot of the Omex stuff probably was and never got translated into text. So you do it that way, but nothing is truly lost. There is ways to do it. You just have to go to the psychic realm. Hello?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hello?
I'm here.
Yeah, so that's
okay,
how you do
so
it.
About, you know, we got trapped in the physical entity, right? You got any books on that as far as, like, when we get trapped in, like, the people, you know what I'm saying, that came down here?
There's so much information, dang.
Because, you know, they left, right?
Huh?
I said
no,
they left,
leave.
You know what I'm saying?
They didn't leave. They left. They
right.
left. They're inside of your body. That's where they are. They didn't leave. They
yeah.
We got trapped into the physical, and our egos developed, and we started thinking that we were real, while our souls were those gods that got trapped in the physical.
So is that what all this about then? So we come in. So I'm. Right. No, I ain't on that. But I'm saying, so.
Your soul used to be this entity, this god.
Right.
And it got trapped into a physical realm and went to sleep, and therefore your ego, the person you think you are, took over and started running things. But the thing you think that left, it didn't left. It's on the inside of you. That's the chakras I was talking about.
And that's what. And so we come. So it's coming back then. That's what all this shit is about,
that's
right?
That's why you having this conversation with me tonight. It's back. Otherwise, you wouldn't be having this conversation. You'd be like, Jesus is the answer. What up when we have in Jesus? You'd be doing some of that shit.
Right.
You see, so it's back. Yes.
All right.
But get a book called Universe, Earth, and Man. Universe, Earth, and Man by Rudolf Steiner. And he goes into some of those things on how we, those vibratory rates fell. Universe, Earth, and Man by Rudolf Steiner, and also get his book Cosmic Memory. Now, he's German, so you have to take your time to read him because he's a hard read because he's German, you know, and stuff like that. Well, he was German. He died in the 30s. But you want to get the book by Rudolf Steiner, Universe, Earth, and Man. You want to get one, Cosmic Memory by him, and that'll go into some of that Atlantean period stuff on how we fell and you know, into this particular predicament. Yes.
Nice.
But the 2012 thing is now. It is a cycle more than it is a date. The date is the artificial thing. You see, it is now. It's happening now as we speak. This is a 2012 event that we are having tonight.
Yes, it is. Well, Brother Bobby, we have 5 minutes left to go in the forum. I definitely want to invite you to come back. You're always welcome here to come share on the Renew Family. And just go ahead. I was going to let you kind of sum it up to know what we're going to be moving into to continue this.
The gods are here. You got to pay attention to those chakras. I want you to get that Revelation book. And it's a step-by-step guide, Revelation of St. John by Zachary F. Lansdowney. And in that particular book, Understanding the Periods of Apocalypse, Kundalini Rising, it talks about the glamour, the Maya, and it talks about all these particular things, the union with the soul. It is an excellent read. I want you to get that. And, you know, and just get a diary and just start jotting down the smaller things that you might think, and that world will appear before you. You see. Are you still on?
Yes,
hello?
We are.
Yes.
We're still here, Brother Bobby.
Yes, and so just do some of those things, you know, and just continue. I mean, it's there. You just got to pay attention to it and stop looking for it to come. It is already here, and it's going to start accelerating, especially when you put your mind to it. But right now, you can put your mind to creating what you want in your everyday life because that's the way the power and the Kundalini energy is so powerful in us now until you create what you want around you. So, like I said, if you want to get the stimulus packages, you want to get the picture packet, which we're really pushing, the stimulus package, which is doing wonders, and some of those other things I mentioned on the tape throughout the tape, you need to call 678-358-1055 to get down with those things. Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Linda will be standing by. So we'll be standing by. It's not a number to hobnob. It's a number to get the orders and stuff like that. So you probably won't catch me in on them numbers, but you will be able to get in contact with Linda, and she can give you some of these products. Yes.
Yes, yes. Wonderful, wonderful. Making sure Remix Family, you guys do reach out so that you please ask your question for Brother Bobby Hemet.
Hello?
312?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, we can.
Yeah, all right. You know, people be talking about all this 2012 and shit. Like, I don't really think they understand what's going on, and I'm really tired of them asking questions. I want to know as far as, like, the solar system is concerned, because
it existed in a time when it was, they were actually, whoever built those heads, they were actually, those Olmecs were the gods. They were
right.
A deity system. They were a deity system. And so there's only one way to do it. That means that the information about them was oral and never was translated into text.
Just, you got Kundalini as far as the other planets is like heating up also. Is this just for the solar system or is it going for the whole universe?
No, this is the whole universe.
That's what I thought. And what about the Olmecs? Like, they talk about, I'm trying to find information on the Olmecs, and it's like very little information. You know what I'm saying? You got anything?
Yes,
you know what I'm saying? Further?
There's one book that came out recently on them, but I'm going to tell you what the Olmecs are. The Olmecs, it's Zuli Danta. There's two Venuses. There's a Venus, that's Urzuli Frida, and then there's Urzuli Danta, which is more of the African type one. Urzuli Frida is a mulatto that formulates in the West. Urzuli Danta is one that comes from the continent. And so that image of that African Venus for the people is the only two color pictures you get, but that one is also Urzuli Danta and all. And she has her story when you deal with mythology. Yes. All right.
All right.
All right, you too. Thank you for calling in. Let's see if we can get another question in here. We have 11 minutes to go, so next caller calling in from area code 312.